Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Mr. Agrawal. Am I audible to you? Mr. Ashish? Mr. Rawat? Am I audible to you?
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, yes, we can hear you now. Thank you.
Yeah.
So good evening and welcome to the second road safety audit auditor certification course at IIT Roorkee in association with Morth and IRC. I would like to give a brief introduction of our speakers for fourth session, fourth lecture. Mr. M.S. Rawat, Mr. Manmohan Rawat is Vice President at AECOM India Private Limited. He has M.Tech in Transportation Engineering from our institute, IIT Roorkee, and Masters in Economics. He's a member of Institution of Highways and Transportation UK, life member of IRC India, member and co-convener of Technical Committees H1 of IRC. Then Apex Highway Specification and Standards Committee of IRC. He has more than 35 years of work ex in the associated field. Together with him, we have also his colleague, Mr. Ashish Agrawal. He's an associate director at AECOM in Transportation Business Line. He holds a bachelor's in civil engineering from our institute, IIT Roorkee. He also has more than 20 years of professional experience working on transportation infrastructure development projects with emphasis on the road safety issues. He has completed safety audit of projects at design stage for under construction projects and black spots study for various different projects. So I welcome to Mr. Rawat and Mr. Agrawal to our campus. You are our alumnus, so it is very happy to welcome from department side as well as the course coordinator. So session is all yours, please.
Hello, good afternoon to all participants. Can you hear me comfortably?
Yes,
you're loud. Okay, so a brief introduction has already been given, and we both are product of University of Roorkee. That's the very good thing that we are able to provide and share our knowledge with our juniors, colleagues, and professors there. And now this is our second session regarding road sign, road markings, and delineation. I have also worked a lot on the road sign marking. It is more related to safety aspect. So what we are going to discuss, that what are the provisions which are given in the IRC course or international publication, how they are used, and how sometimes we have to think out of the box also when we are applying these guidelines which are given in the publications. Specifically, Ashish Agrawal has done a lot of work on this thing. And many of the places he has taken deviation from the standard guidelines to make it a more project specific. And that's the way, because whatever is written in the Indian Road Congress or other publication, these are the guidelines. We should not just have a hard bounding to be governed by those guidelines. We have to make application of those guidelines to the project specific. So that is the main crux what I have discussed. Ashish Agrawal will continue on these issues in detail. and he has good case studies also. So he will continue on that aspect. Thank you, Ashish.
Thank you, sir.
You can continue.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Let me share. Is my presentation seen by all?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So presentation is on road signs, road marking and delineation. Mr. Rawat said, this is rightly said, this road sign, there some guidelines are given in the code, but still site specific requirement sometimes is not being captured properly in the guidelines, because guidelines are very generic in nature. So we have to think out of the box, and we have to think as per site requirement, and based on the site requirement, we can be very specific what kind of sign, what kind of solution we have to provide at this solution, so that it serves the purpose. So let me start with the basic this thing. I have divided this presentation in two parts. One is road sign and second is road signs, road markings and delineators. The first part, road signs, first I will include these five components of road signs. These are purpose of road sign. So it is very important to understand the purpose of the road sign, so that you can at site, you can appreciate how that road sign will serve the purpose. So by anyhow, we have to manage that the road sign should serve the purpose. That's the basic idea, irrespective of whatever is given in the guidelines. Then we have to be very specific as per guideline to have a common kind of this thing. So there should be shape, color and size of the road sign. This should be exactly as per the guidelines required. Then maintenance of road sign is very important, which often is left out. So those things also we try to capture here. Then there are recent innovation in the road sign. They are not being captured in the guidelines sometimes, because our codes are like they get updated once in 5 years or 4 years. So sometimes innovation come in between. So we can also make use of innovation to have some site specific requirement to make that, to fulfill that site requirement. Then we have the component of road signs. There the sheeting of the road sign is very important, and how to choose it and what the guidelines say, that we will discuss. So let's start with the presentation. The first is the purpose of the road sign. If you understand this properly, so you will be able to make a good decision at site specific decision. So there are five components of road signs. The road sign should fulfill a need. Clear and simple meaning. The message should be clear, because a rider gets a very small fraction of time to see the road sign. So the message should be very clear and simple. Adequate response time. We should have, if we are showing some kind of a junction, so it has to be some 40-50 meter before the junction, so that it gets an adequate time. If we want to give the indicator and all those kind of things, so that kind of response time should be there. Command respect. The sign should be very clear and very in such a way that it should attract the command. It should be visible throughout the day. Then it should attract the attention of the road user. So those five parameters we have to ensure while designing or while proposing any road sign. So first is fulfill the limit. Like I have taken one example from the speed limit thing. Okay, now we want to enforce speed limit. So we have separate speed limit for different classes of vehicle on NH, we have seen. So along with high speed, also specify minimum speed. This is something which we don't feel the need in Indian highways, but outside India, this has been felt, and this is very much required, that speed limit on highway. It should not happen that some vehicle is driving at a very low speed, then it's like choking one lane of the multi-lane highway. So we should have some borderline to that also, that minimum speed has to be this much. Otherwise, if we want to stop somewhere or this paved shoulder and all those kind of features are there. So this is the criteria which our code don't capture, but this somewhere outside India, they use it. Speed enforcement through speed camera. This is something new. They put a gantry on the multi-lane highway. Then they give in airport, near airport and near big highway, you have seen you might have seen this, that there they specify the what speed you are driving. So this captures the attention of the road user, and then based on the speed, they can also give challan to you. Each challan kind of thing is there, so that way they can charge you from that. So those kind of new things they are coming. So this is first, which is like then the second is command attention. Command attention means it should be visible to the road user. There are so many road signs sometimes that it become difficult for the road user, and sometimes the visibility is such low that, like in tunnels or during the night time, sometimes street lights are not there. So at those kind of time, so we can make use of these fluorescent signs, and sometimes we can use sign with a background, so it becomes more visible. So in urban section, we sometimes recommend signs to be used with a background, so that the sign is more visible to the road user, so that what is intended from that road user during the this working time, so it should, he should follow that. So there is pupil at work. This is work zone sign, which I have shown in the bottom right side, and then speed limit sign, zebra crossing. Zebra crossing and school, these are two critical location, because when pedestrian are more number of pedestrians are there, so road user has to be within safe limit, and he should get this idea that something important or some pedestrian crossing is there. Similarly, convey a clear and simple meaning. So our road sign, generally you see they are in sign language. Matlab, it means ke bhi ye, irrespective of the language, whether he is literate or illiterate, he can see the sign and follow it. So those kind of guidelines, those kind of system has been developed. There are two signs. They are generally in circle, triangle, and rectangular form. You all know that. You might have studied in the previous this thing. Only two signages are there, which have a special unique this thing, unique shape, that is stop sign and give way sign. They are in language form, but they have a unique shape so that they convey the message to the road user. Similarly, we have added this thing, like stop sign is one of the most important road sign we have on road, because stop means stop. By any manner, you have to stop because some hazard, some danger is there. So what they have come up is, earlier that stop sign used to be there, this octagonal sign, and now they have come up with definition plate. Below that stop sign, we mention that you will be penalized by this much amount if you don't follow this road sign. Because whatever way we can, we have to safeguard the road user. So even if he is not stopping by a simple manner, so we have to show him that this much of penalty will be imposed on you if you don't follow this sign, because this is for his own safety. Similarly, on speed signs, we can have this kind of speed camera kind of sign we have shown. So that way, he should be aware ke bhi you are under surveillance. You are being monitored through cameras, and if you don't follow this speed limit, you will be charged. So these are the kind of new things which we have added in the road signs, and they sometimes are helpful, because by facing penalty and by facing these charges, people became more cautious, more prone towards those signs. Now the next part of this, next important purpose of this thing, is adequate time to respond. The problem is with the concept of this multi-lane highways, it has become very important that more and more gantry has to be there, because shoulder mounted sign cannot fulfill the need, because it can be for one lane, but for multi-lane there has to be a gantry, and on gantry we have to mention these direction signs, and we also have to have these direction sign. We have in three part. One is, first is direct advanced direction sign, then there is on also confirmatory direction sign, so that, because anywhere in the expressway we don't have many U-turn and all those facilities, so he, whatever road user, wherever his destination is, he should get the clear idea so that he can leave the expressway there and only. If he try to take a U-turn, it will not be easy, it will not be feasible on the expressway. So it is very important that we have this advanced direction sign, then we should have this confirmatory direction sign. So by all means, we should give the clear message to the road user. Now after the after we have finished the purpose of the road sign, now the important aspect of road sign, how to decide the shape, color and size of the road sign. For shape, you might have you must have written, you have must have the presentation on the road sign. Okay, there are three type of sign and they are defined by a particular shape. Color, generally this color is not applicable for first two kind of sign, like warning sign and cautionary sign. And color is more important for information giving sign. So they have a different kind of pattern for road based on road classification. Then size of road sign. Size of road sign is defined by the design speed. More the speed, more larger should be the size of the road sign. Larger should be the size of the text on that sign, so that it is visible at a high speed in fraction of time, and it should be clearly visible at a high speed. So these are the three basic parameters. This you have already gone. So here I would like to add that this mandatory and regulatory sign, they come with this violation is legal offense. These signs are regulatory, and by anyhow you have to follow these road signs. These are so important. So at the same time, we carry the obligation as a PWD engineer or as a safety expert, okay, these road signs should be at the right place. If we put these road sign anywhere, then we should not expect that people will follow, and we should not charge them for the violation. So similarly, these stop sign and give way sign, they are also part of this mandatory and regulatory sign, and any violation is a legal offense. So this is very important for this particular sign. Cautionary and warning sign is like we are guiding the road user that some hazard is there, please slow down or something. Similarly, this information guide sign, this is also a guiding kind of sign. But these mandatory and regulatory sign, they are like you have to have it, otherwise you will become problem for others. So this is the critical aspect of this mandatory and regulatory sign. That's why they carry this.
I think there is some network connectivity issue, so give them a few minutes, maybe he would be joining back. Mr. Ashish.
I'll try to speak to
him more formally. Mr. Ashish, we lost you in between. Mr. Ashish? Mr. Ashish
is trying to get it connected.
Okay, fine.
I spoke to him. I don't know somehow he got disconnected.
Yeah, could be some network problem. No worries.
Yeah. And you see, he has got a good case studies also. And nowadays, regarding this cautionary warning information, you see, nowadays we have Google with us. So everybody gets direction generally governed by the Google, the direction, other things. So the commuters are not depending much on the information sign, and information sign, rarely they read it. Gradually the kilometer stone and milestone, there also people are not referring to for any reference. They are governed by the Google image, but the Google image also has this facility. If the particular road is locked, let us say for 10 days because of the maintenance. So it can be loaded on the Google image and they will keep that particular section of the road which is under maintenance. It will show as a block or to take some other path. So that facility is also there. So he will share that part also. I think Ashish got connected. Ashish?
Hello.
Hello, Ashish. Hello, Ashish, can you hear me? Hello?
We can hear you. We can hear you.
Yeah, but if provided Ashish can hear me, I can. He was not able to share the screen, the presentation which I have shared. Ashish, I have shared your screen. If you can continue. Can you see the screen? Then you can try sharing, I'll stop it.
Right, sir. Is my screen
Hello,
sir.
Got connected.
Mr. Ashish, I think you have to mute at least one of the devices. Keep a speaker and microphone muted. Otherwise, there will be some echo.
Yeah.
Yes, we can see the fifth slide, the mode specification for road markings.
Okay. I should share again. Okay.
Yes, I think it would be nice if you can start at slide 12. We were not able to hear you from there. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks, ma'am. Nice. Voice is still getting echo. I am connected twice.
Yeah, but we are not getting any echo. I think at our end, it's fine.
Okay. Ashish, you are getting echo.
No. Now it's okay. I think I just, whenever I was trying to connect, so it has been connected twice.
Okay. Yeah, it got connected twice. Okay. Then only echo comes. Yes. Okay. It happened with me also. Yeah, please.
So let me start with this slide number 12. Now here I was asking, telling about the shape of the road sign. So the shape of the road sign, as in the previous presentation, you must have read KBA. It is based on the classification of the road sign. It is mandatory, cautionary, and information. And for mandatory sign, because they are mandatory in nature or regulatory in nature, and any violation can have a similar impact or a crash impact on other road user. So any violation is a legal offense. So these mandatory signs are critical in that sense. Cautionary sign is something like, it is to warn you against some hazard, some sharp curve or something. Similarly, information sign, they are usually to provide the information. That information can be about some facility or about some place to destination. Similarly, this stop sign and give way sign, they are also part of this mandatory sign, and any violation is a legal offense. This is very important because these signs, as a road safety expert or as a site in charge, we should take care that these signs are placed at the right place. Any place where these signs are no more required should be replaced or should be covered, so that wherever these signs are there, they should have a purpose, and any violation can be treated as a legal offense. So, and here I would like to add one thing, that this, the first road sign which we see on any of the road in this world is this stop sign, and that stop sign was in this square in shape at that time. It was in 1950 and at that point. So this is something I have bring in from the history. Now the second part is color pattern. Color pattern of this regulatory and warning sign are same for all classification of road, except this information sign. These information sign, they have a different color based on the road classification. Like NH, SH, MDR, they generally have a green background information sign boards. And similarly, expressway and urban road, they have a blue base. And ODR village road, they have a white. So here I have also mentioned that regulatory sign, there are total 57 types of regulatory sign we have as per IRC 67, and 78 types of warning sign and 80 type of information sign. These information sign are further categorized into 5 category, so that you can always go through the IRC code, and they are generally rectangular in shape. Then the size of the road sign, this is based on design speed. Very rightly, more the speed, more the size of the road sign should be, and so that the information which we are trying to communicate through the sign should the road user should capture within fraction of second he get while passing through the road. So similarly, I have just mentioned here that up to 65 kilometer sign, we have a small kind of regulator sign. This is 600 mm dial. And similarly for warning sign, and similarly for information sign. Here I have also mentioned that there are some 5 types of information sign. This is place information sign, which we call this direction or some destination sign. Facility information sign, these are like petrol pump, some eating, this thing is there. Similarly, parking sign is there. They are also specified. Persons with disability, they are specific signs for persons with disability. Then there are route marker, like we have NH or Asian Highway and all those kind of marking we have from the road. So these are the kind of road signs we have in our roads. Now, this is one important parameter which generally is missed out and which create lot of problem at site. This is maintenance of roads. As per code, it is equally important, or it is very important, that some maintenance schedule should be there prior to installing any road sign. Whosoever agency install the road sign at site should also develop a schedule, maintenance schedule, how that sign will be maintained, because these road signs don't have a infinite life. They have some standard life, some depending upon the type of sheeting and all those things, they have sometimes 5 to 7 years of life, sometimes 10 year and sometimes 15 year. So it is based on the type of the sign you use, the quality of the sign you use at the time of installing. So you have to have a maintenance schedule, and beside replacing those sign, you also need to maintain it. Like no mud should be there. They should be visible. If some damage is there, so you need to replace it. You need to, because these sign, as we understand, they carry great importance. They communicate. They are our type for the road user. They are only guiding us there. We are also putting some mandatory or regulatory sign. And if those sign are not visible, not clear, then how is it we can expect road user to follow them? And the absence of sign can become a cause of accident. Then the reason for that is not on the road user. Similarly, now some new thing has come up. There is a reference number on the backside of the sign. So that reference number is like who is the manufacturer, because there are a number of manufacturer, and we need that repair can be done easily by that manufacturer. So we can have that kind of mechanism who has developed, and we generally have a warranty card also from them. If anything happened before that guarantee lapses, so we can always go and ask them, okay, this reference number, you have developed this road sign and you need to repair it. Similarly, there is inclusion of replacement clause at the end of warranty period. So this is very much important because we have fund. Yeah, am I audible?
Your concern.
Am I audible, please?
Yes, you are audible. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So similarly, inclusion of replacement clause is very important to be part of the maintenance, because our road may end a little longer, but road signs, they may need replacement before that. Signs should be cleaned at regular intervals. This is one part, because our roads are dusty sometimes and that creates a lot of dust getting accumulated and we need to clean them. Inspection of sign at least twice a year, both day and night. So it is very important that sign should be visible at the daytime as well as at the night time. And once and we need to inspect it twice a year. These are the guidelines given in the code, in the orange book. So these kind of practices are generally not followed. So this has become very important, because the road signs carry a lot of importance and they should communicate the same message which we want. So similarly, damage signs shall be replaceability. So these are few of the important parameters which we should keep always in mind. Okay, what is the maintenance schedule of that road sign at the time of installing it, of road sign. And we should also here, I would like to add, many of the road sign with time, like if we have some zebra crossing and then some subway has come up, so that zebra crossing is not required. Yeah, median cut sign you have given and median cut has been not been required there, so it has been some raised median has been created there. So in that case, those signs should be removed, or if not removed, then they should be covered, because any road sign giving a false message is also not good. As a road user, as a road safety expert, we should always ensure the right sign should be there at the right place. Now I will talk about the innovations in road sign. The best innovation in road sign, which I think IRC also including in their latest edition of 2020 draft, I've seen. This is the digital printed road sign. Earlier, we have those road signs which take too much of time. This is like printing. So here we can also include the photograph of those features from tourist destination and all those kind of thing. So those kind of facility we have with this digital printing of sign, and they have more life. Like I have mentioned earlier, the earlier sign were having 7 year or 10 year of life. Now this road sign, they claim it is 15 year of life, and they have a barcode also. With that code, scanning that code, you will get when it was printed and who is the agency who is holding this, and all those kind of information you will get with this QR code. This is the innovation, or this is the new thing which is there in the market and which we can make use of to make our road sign more friendly. Now I just give you a basic idea as on date what we are using is the conventional method is screen printing, and that it involves more number of steps, labor intensive, time consuming, and there are chances of getting some fault while making that sign. So here it is a printed, once it is developed on a computer, then just after confirming that you can have multiple prints. So it will not be a labor intensive, so it is more likely to be less mistakes will be there. Similarly, we have direction information sign to this place. There we can have this brown color is being recommended in Western countries. So at some of the places I've seen, maybe India also start using this. So these kind of changes we can make to make this tourist place and all those or all together more seen by the road user for effective. Similarly, the last point which I will take is the component of road sign. So here, beside this civil work support structure, you all might have studied till now that only tubular structures are allowed. Like it can be a circular, it can be a square, or it can be a rectangular, but it has to be a tubular, rounded kind of thing should have been there, because it in itself it should not be a hazard for the road user. So So using angle iron and all those things are generally not recommended. Similarly, structure, back support frame has to be there. Then substrate is there that can be aluminium or composite material. Then the most important part of this is retroreflective. Retroreflective is a very particular thing, and generally less retroreflective or not retroreflective generally don't work during the night hours. So few slides I will take for the retroreflective. This is something the most specification says. The posts are tubular, either circular, rectangular, square. As I also mentioned, angle iron is not allowed as per this orange book. All sign bolts shall be painted gray on the back. This is important because the road sign, this is visible for one side, and for the other side user, like for a two-lane road. So the vehicle coming from the other direction, they will also see the road sign and they will see the back of the road. No distraction should be there, so it should be painted gray. It should not be visible to them. But it should not give any wrong message to them. So for that, it is mentioned that they should be painted gray in the back. Sign shall be dated on the fabrication with inedible ink. So earlier it used to be on the back of the sign, we used to have a date of fabrication so that we can have the guarantee and warranty in place. Now new QR code system has come up, which I have shown in the digital printing. So that way also we can take care of this road sign, the warranty and guarantee. Certificate that to be submitted with all the test report. Now it is very important, which I don't know whether these agencies take or not. The certificate from the vendor, it has to be taken. It should serve its desired life, and it should have the kind of a retroreflectivity it has to. All tests to be done in government laboratory. Tests should be done. The science, road signs have the proper retroreflectivity. So now I will have few slides because this is very important for road sign to be visible during night time. So reflection, retroreflection is different because the more the light it falls on the road sign and the more it reflects back towards the person is called retroreflectivity. And we have n number of sheets, like 11 number of sheets. So, and why we need this retroreflectivity, that I will also discuss. So retroreflectivity is required because we have a very heterogeneous mix on our road. Basically, this is on some city road, we have the photograph. Different observation angle is there. So at a different observation, the retroreflectivity will be different. Large truck have least twice observation angle as sedan, the car we have. Higher the observation angle, higher grade of sheeting will be required. So these are the kind of parameters which we need to follow in the retroreflective sheeting, in the selection of the retroreflective sheeting. Similarly, age factor. It is not same that all people of all age group will see the retroreflectivity in the same line. So it is very important that we have to make our road safe, our road sign visible to all age group and at all time of the day. Similarly, headlamp of light. Sometimes you have seen beyond our roads. Sometimes the headlights are so bright, so much of glare is there, so you may not be able to see the road sign. If you miss the road sign, so it very chances that you will not follow that rule which is bound there. So for that, road sign should be more visible. Then visual cutter, this is the common practice. This I have taken from Bologna itself, my home place. So there are so many of these advertisement and all those kind of PWD marking and police station and all those. Even this barricades also, they are full of advertisement and all. So our road sign should be visible. So for that, all these, this is little costly. So we expect these advertisement will not have that kind of activity as compared with the road sign. So this is one other reason, visual cutter. So for that, we should have a good retroreflective system. So this is IRC 67-2012, and in the latest edition, recommended in the IRC 67-2020 draft. I have seen the draft of this IRC 67, and here they have this, they are going to a higher class of retroreflective sheeting for each type of expressway or national highway, because we are having a higher speed, we have multi-lane highways, So with that requirement, we need a more retroreflective sheeting. So this is also included in the IRC 67-2020 draft. It is the QR code system to be part of the road sign. So with this, we expect we will have more better maintenance quality of the road signs, because this will give us the quick first-hand information who is the vendor of this road sign and warranty is hold with them. Okay, and after this, I will show you some snaps from the site I am supervising as a road safety expert. This is Dwarka Expressway. I will show you photograph of work zone because this is under construction. And then I will have a case study from other projects, good and bad practices. So these are the two things we will capture in next few slides. This is Dwarka Expressway. This is 8.5 kilometer of elevated road. So here you see instead of flagman is there, but flagman may or may not remain there for the long hour working hours. So we have a sign also which is like a flagman, and he is also mentioning go slow. So these kind of signs sometimes are more helpful, more visible to road users, and they will be there as long as you wish. So these kind of practices can be followed while doing some maintenance work on the road, on the running carriage. This is also a kind of road sign. So generally, you might have studied. It is important to note the work zone sign. They generally have a yellow background, and sometimes a red background, so that they are more appealing to the road user. If some work zone is there, and work zone is full of surprises. So let's be very clear. These kind of signs. Then these are the kind of barricade. Also, you can paste the visibility or delineation, plus at the same time you can have the board about those road signs, barricades to mark the traffic diversion, work in progress, go slow, stop, and all those kind of road signs. These are generally used on temporary traffic area. Wherever the traffic is straight, you not need so much of road signs, but otherwise at every diversion it should be very clear. Otherwise to tell the road user that some temporary diversion is there. So this is, I have taken the photo during the night time, these road signs, how they are visible and how much reflectivity they carry. This is one other photo. This is the traffic calming measure, which generally any speed breaker and all those kind we cannot give. So this by this way we can have a traffic calming during the this work zone and the running carriage. Now I have captured something about road signs. Are we doing correctly? Are we placing road sign at right place? This is very important. In the first few slides, I have given the purpose of the road sign. So it is very important for all of us to place the road sign at a correct place. It should give adequate time. It should have the right purpose. It should have right size, it should have right shape, it should have right reflectivity, so that all road users can see the road sign at a right time. Are we using right type of retroreflection? This is very important, because this is a costly item, and sometimes because of some cost cutting or because of some saving, they generally don't use the retroreflectivity. Or even if they use, so there are chances it will not last it desired life. If it is for 7 years, it will fade in 2 or 3 years, then it will not serve the purpose. So those kind of thing in the maintenance and in the pre-decision making time, we need to be very careful. Are we removing defunct road signs? This is very important, because many places I have seen these defunct road signs are there, and with changing scenario, they have not been removed, neither been covered nor been removed. So they are giving a false message, and this is it's a human tendency. If you show them false signs, so people may get into they start disobeying that road signs. So it is very important we give them the right sign at the right place, so that they keep following it and they keep obeying the respecting the road sign. Are we maintaining road sign in acceptable condition? This is very important, which we have already discussed. like a maintaining of road sign is very, very important. So, as a operator or as a road in charge or road agency, we always have take care that we should have roads right sign at right place and giving the right information. This is a stop sign. This is wrongly placed. Stop sign is generally placed at the junction, wherever some good road is meeting this small junction. So where we have, and there are some gap. Bottom SPP sign is placed 1.5 to 6 meter from the stop line. So those road signs and this markings together they serve the purpose. So it has to be placed at the correct place. So these are the few signs where. Similarly, this is zebra crossing there, and some subway has also come up. So it is like this sign has no longer important. So it should be removed or it should be covered. Similarly, non-uniform speed limit sign. I don't know how this come up at few of the roads, and there are two or three signs, and they are having a different speed limit sign. So this is not advisable. Yeah, this is not acceptable. So having a wrong message will not make any good for us as agency, as a road user, as a safety expert. Similarly, two signs, one is parking, one is no parking. So this is also a confusing road sign and will create chaos for the road users. Now I will take two slide studies from KMP. So KMP is Kundli Maneswar Palwal Expressway, also called as Western Peripheral Expressway. So there, one of the sign, advanced direction sign, there are too many of destination names are printed, and because of so many of destination name, they become so small that nothing is visible. So this is something we commented, okay, this sign shows 12 destinations, so many destination, one signboard cannot be read by driver. Driver don't have that much of time. So it has to be very specific. It has to be like 2-3 signs at the most, so that direction signs, so that he can take a decision in a fraction of time he get during driving. Similarly, non-standard or wrong traffic sign. This sign is not a traffic sign. Moreover, it contain advertisement and wrong depiction of any number. So, matlab, these kind of thing. Even I will add here. Okay, even this logo of NHI sometimes is not required. If you at the time of welcome or at the time of entering the expressway, you can mention NHI welcomes you or something. But on eating space on the road sign, because giving some logo and something is not advisable, because that will eat up to the space. We have limited space for road sign. Similarly, seat belt ka long itna, having such a long message will not serve any purpose. These are not a standard sign and should not be used. Similarly, there are some things from the design generally. They are not that visible, but such chevron sign at this location and alignment are not required and may cause confusion. So these marking. So I will also show you that there has to be a detailed drawing showing where what signs we are providing, and also detailed drawing showing what lane marking or what markings we are giving. So that there has to be a separate drawing. That sometimes we don't make and we let it on the laborer or on the basic team who used to do this work for us at site, and sometimes they end up doing something very wrong. So those things we should avoid. We should be present, or we should have a detailed drawing so that no mistake is done at site. Because once some mistake is done at site, correction will, it becomes a very difficult part, and then it end up KBA for long time it used to be there. Similarly, here picture of truck shown as 100 km per hour, which is wrong. Here the speed of car was 120 and for truck was 80. So it was wrongly mentioned. Is similarly something from the Western world, they have used keep adequate distance of 70 meter, neither based on Indian nor international standard. It does not appear to be based. Generally, they say 2 car length or 3 car length. Generally, that much distance you have to keep. So that way, that kind of measure they used to give. Similarly, here also location and configuration is horribly wrong, reflecting very poor professional capability. Right turning arrow shown on divided carriageway. So these kind of wrong picturization in the last bottom right last sign. If you see, one sign is showing up, one sign is showing down. So they are like wrongly printed or wrongly prepared, and they are just put on the road. Next is road marking and delineation. Let me open that. Any questions so far?
No, sir, not such.
Mr. Ashish?
Yeah.
So are you done with this?
Sorry?
Can we have some question answer now?
Yes, please.
Okay, so dear participants, please feel free to ask questions.
Is the stop sign respected? Do people stop at junctions if they have a stop control? Or at a priority junction?
They should.
Do they?
That depends. That is a very general question. They should, because since we are not, sometimes we are not providing the sign at the right place, sometimes it is not supported with this lane marking and all those kind of things. So generally people sometimes ignore them or disrespect them. So what I clearly indicate here is, if we provide the road sign at the right place and we keep maintaining them, and if we keep them in defunct sign, we remove at site, so slowly and surely people will start obeying them or respecting them. So it is very important, because this is for their own safety.
Yes.
As an agency, as a road safety expert, we are supposed to make sure that we provide the road sign at the right place, and right information should be there, and it should be rightly required there.
These signs also form a legal binding in case there is a crash or a collision. When a traffic inspector, a police comes to site, he has a clear decision to make who's at fault and who was not at fault. Somebody had to stop or give way, and because he was at a minor junction. Yeah, but he didn't, and that is the reason of the crash. Hence I ask these questions, because I have seen this whenever I come to India, that people from the minor road are suddenly turning into the main line, expecting the person on the main road to break or to yield for him, just as though it's his right of way. There is a big confusion with exactly who has priority at junctions.
Surely, yes, that is the problem.
See, I would like to add another issue on this part. There is a lack of coordination between the engineering department and the enforcement department. You see, when the construction work is going on, the contractor responsibilities, there are 50 signboards, they have been fixed, that's all, he will get payment for 50. Or if it is a BOT project, he has to provide 50 signboards at different places. Rarely it happens that some engineer or senior person is going, whether their location is appropriate or not. Subsequently, wherever it has been fixed, that will be used by each and every commuter. And whatever this kind of incident or accident happens, it becomes the sort of a reason for that. So there's a lack of coordination between the engineering and enforcement. If subsequently the enforcement division, the police department, find the sign is not at right place, they will rarely inform that engineering department to shift it at right place. So this is also a problem with our roads.
Yes, sir. This is exactly where a road safety audit comes to place, where an expert with a road safety hat would go to site to make sure that the signs are adequately placed at the right, at the right location, with the right spacing from the carriageway, so that the road user can make the decision appropriately. Yeah, the contractor doesn't have these skill sets. The contractor just sees a drawing which is just showing the sign, but it doesn't really show where the sign has to be placed. So this is where a road safety expert or somebody during construction, a RE or a ARE, they have to make sure that these signs are placed at least meeting to the standards or the codes of the country.
That is good nowadays. Government of India means Ministry of Road Transport, Highway, NHAI, and state PWDs. They have started appointing independent road audit, the safety audit agency, so that they have nothing to do with the contractor, even the present client also, or the enforcement. They will give an independent audit report. So that's the good practice they have started now.
I have a question.
Yes.
In case you have multiple signboards to be placed, say almost at the same location, so are there any guidelines that they should be separated by certain distances, or yes, that in a same signboard you could depict more than one or two?
That is mainly for the information sign, where we have advanced sign, then direction sign, then confirmatory sign. But yes, there is a guideline that to be visible those road signs, there has to be some minimum gap, and that is based on design speed. That is guided by design speed. So some distance has to be maintained so that all signs are visible appropriately to the road user.
I would just want to add a small information to everybody, just to mention that in a Western country, if you talk about Sweden, UK, Netherlands, if anybody were to meet with a collision and a sign was not placed or it was hit in an accident earlier and not replaced, then they can be taken to court. The authority has to pay huge financial consequences. Hence, they are very, very robust with their maintenance regime to make sure that signs are either maintained, or if they are hit through collisions, they are all reinstated before any other event happens.
Yes, very rightly said. In Delhi itself, if right now they have started imposing penalty for disobeying this speed limit sign, but at the same time, when there were too many number of this penalties or charges, then people start claiming that the speed limit sign is wrong. So that way is a two-way process. Once you start making the enforcement agency start making more strict, more enforcement is there, then they also parallelly road users start challenging whether this sign is appropriate or not. Why so many people are disobeying this sign? So that way it is to and fro process, so that we have a improved system. In India, road sign sometimes, which I have seen, maintenance is overlooked, road sign appropriate location is overlooked. So those kind of issues are there. So they are going like hand in hand in some of the places in Delhi, I've seen. Right. So let me start with the road markings. Are my slides visible?
Yes.
Yes. Please.
Okay. So now, since road signs are equally important, but now I will give you the merits of road markings. Nowadays in India we are having multi-lane roads. So for providing road sign on a multi-lane road, shoulder mounted sign are no longer valid. Only gantry sign can be there, and we cannot have so many of gantry. So sometimes this lane marking plays a very important role, and very longitudinally also they can guide us. Then ghost island kind of thing we can provide, like if some bus bay is there, so instead of providing any physical island, we can provide ghost island kind of thing. Even for rotary also sometimes we provide ghost island. Then depressed median also there, this lane marking only will help us, or we can have some audible markings on the shoulder side or on the median side, so that these markings, and they are longitudinal in nature, we can provide in a length, whereas road signs they are at one some place only. So these are the advantages of road sign, and with that we start our presentation on road markings. This is India's first 14-lane highway. This is Meerut Expressway. You see this many of lanes. It is with marking only we can make out these are the lanes where you have to move, where zebra crossing is there. So all those kind of features, even speed limit and all that, all kind of important information also we start giving with the marking, and they are effective. I will show you some slides on that also in the subsequent slides. Now I will come to the MORTH specification. I will just give you a basic idea. This is hot applied. These are covered in MORTH specification. We can always go through these things, and they are hot applied thermoplastic road marking and cold applied reflective paint, 30% by weight. Beads set are mixed with the paint, and in the cold applied, the beads are spread at 30 gram per square meter. These are the specifications we have. Pavement temperature shall be more than 10 degrees Celsius. We should not apply it on a very old pavement. Similarly, pavement temperature shall not be more than 40 degrees in case of this cold applied. These are further, it is mixed with plasticizer resins and fast drying time and highly durable. This is some comparison of coat, some favorable things of hot applied thermoplastic paint markings and this cold applied reflective paint. This is more or less from mainly from this orange book, right? These are the beads. So this is very important because glass beads, they have a similar action. The same way they have a retro reflective nature for road sign. Similarly, these glass beads will help in the retro reflectivity of this road markings. Now we have come up with some even bigger this thing. This is wet retro reflective marking. They are visible, equally visible during the wet, during the rains, during the whether sunny or rainy, then rains time. So these kind of thing, these are, I have given some picture also of the beads. These are the very small size, granular, circular, yeah, spherical glass beads. So these should be rounded and all those kind of property we used to see. So properties of finished road marking, the strip shall not be slippery when wet, marking shall not lift from pavement in freezing weather. So here it is more important. The maintenance of this marking is very, very important because whenever you lay some new layer of BT, this marking will have to be done again. And again, the life of this marking is like 2 to 3 years. And generally you do the overlay in 5 years. So in between two overlay also, you have to have this marking. And prior to putting all those things, prior to making these decisions, you should have that maintenance schedule when you will redo these markings. So this is very important. This carry a lot of information for the road users. At the same time, these need a more maintenance kind of thing. Now we have different color of marking. Generally in India, white is recommended. Earlier, yellow marking was recommended on cement concrete pavement. Now white is recommended through some circular. So this is the most widely used color for road marking because of its visibility and good contrast against the road surface. Yellow color is also used in slow parking restriction. Yellow color is generally is same in nature as white, but it is like more hazard. Some wherever on the side curb, if some this junction is there or some bus shelter is there, so there we have this, instead of white and black marking on the curb stones, we have yellow and black marking. So this is the indication that it is more hazardous or more. And blue color is generally for public transport. I have not seen it much in India, but during this Commonwealth game and all those, so there then they put one lane especially for this Commonwealth games vehicles. So that time they put this blue kind of square or rectangles on the road, and they work very effectively. Red and purple, red color marking is recommended in hazardous intersection and places where pedestrian meet motorized traffic. I will show you some examples of all these. These are being started using in India, and in Gurgaon, I have taken some photograph near my office and all those places to show you. This is audible and vibratory paper marking. This is very good thing that this has come up because anyone going towards the median side or towards the shoulder side beyond the carriageway. So these kind of audible sound will awake the person if he is little drowsy, or even alert the person if he goes into these things. So these are kind of audible vibratory pavement marking. This is those raised profile edge lines. So these kind of innovation or these kind of new things are coming up to make our road more safe. So we should make good use of them at the right place so that they are more effective and more useful to enhance the safety of road users. And there are zigzag markings and transverse bar marking. These are being used, transverse bar marking, to alert at all the junctions, on the approaches of underpasses, all those locations. They are being widely used in Delhi. I have seen at very many places they are using this transfers who are marking, and they are quite effective, I guess, I'll say. So this is one photograph I have taken in near Huda city center, if anybody of you are aware from Gurgaon. So this is a busy junction. So there they have this white and red line. This is the cycle track, 10 kilometer long, uninterrupted cycle track they have developed in Gurgaon, and it extends from Huda city center to Subhash Chowk. This is 10 kilometer length. Everywhere, wherever it crosses a road, they have this kind of arrangement, and they have marked the cycle track in red. So this is the kind of they have started doing in Gurgaon. This is cycle track crossing with main road. This is the crossing. This is quite reasonably visible and quite effective, and people are using it during early hours and during holidays. Similarly, these are the three consecutive photos I have taken in the Gulf Coast Road. This was designed by our ACOM only. So these are the three photographs. If you see the first photograph, there they have written slow with the pavement markings. Then the transverse bar marking are there in the second photograph, and the third they have given the speed limit. So they are very effective, because with signboard for a multi-lane highway it is difficult, and to provide gantry is also not feasible sometimes. So with this marking they have given the right information to the road user, that slow down, transverse bar marking to slow the speed to alert the driver, and then the speed limit sign. So this is very practical and very good kind example we have on our Gurgaon road. This is a photograph I took from the parking of my office building. This is in Cyber City. So there the throughway, or what should I say, driveway is blue in color, and for pedestrian they have marked a yellow red color width, and it is continued. The continuity is maintained for this driveway and walkway for the pedestrian to keep both of them safe. This is the parking photograph for office building. Then this is the poor maintenance. This is again from the similar photo, but as I said earlier, that this pavement marking, they have a very small life, 2 to 3 years. So if not maintained, then it will not serve its purpose. So they are like faded. They may not be visible during night, but still we have a provision as per our code to provide this cat eye or this kind of thing on all four sides of this strips, so that it is visible out even after fading. So these kind of code specify all these ideas, but still we need to have a good maintenance schedule to keep these road markings in a good condition. Now I will talk about this new technology. There is some temporary pavement marking tapes. It is just like a simple tape that we used to use outside. These are more durable, little costlier, but these kind of tape can be used wherever we need some marking from some crash accident site, where we want it to be more visible, where some road users are making some mistake. So with these marking, we can alert them. We can make them more alert and use the road safely. These are the road studs I have shown in the zebra crossing. Also, these road studs are designed, but these are the solar power road studs and all those kind of road studs. So these are the specification given in this orange book, where retro reflectivity has to be there, some compressive strength is there, height width is there. So these cat eye sometimes are very effective, and on few of the Gurgaon road I have seen this solar powered road studs, and they are very during night hours or during late hours. So they serve the purpose very beautifully. Like they glow and they blink, and they very clearly delineate the roadway. That is the good part. We start using it, and more of these things are being used. So this is some practices of they can be pasted with epoxy or they can be nailed. Nailing is generally not allowed, so this is being fixed with epoxy road studs. Application of road studs, we can have a different color for edge line, different color with center line, and they serve the purpose very, very good way. During night hours, they can guide the road users, they can guide the carriageway. Similarly, there are two color road studs also. white on one side and red on one side. They are generally used on two-way carriageways so that they have they serve the purpose. And similarly, road floods are being used on the center line also, so for bi-directional amber and all those. And chevron marking here also, marking plays a very important role because these chevron marking wherever some different kind of traffic is there or traffic is diverging into two or merging, so there it becomes very important to slowly merge the traffic. So these chevron marking are placed, so these are very useful and they along with these road struts serve the purpose and they are spacing and these guidelines are there. So I have just shown the photograph on the board itself, so you can always go through the board and read in detail about these things. But this is very important. This is very much required on Indian roads. Many of the roads they don't have, so these are very good. But these are very good in ensuring the safety at merging and diverging. So similarly, daytime and nighttime, I have taken photograph of the same location where these road struts are provided in the morning. These lane marking are doing the purpose very beautifully, and during the night time, these road struts are more prominent. So together, we have to address the safety issue. We have to ensure that we communicate the message to the road users. So we can have multiple kind of options. We have road signs, we have markings, we have road struts, we have delineators. So together with all those things, we can make the thing we want to communicate to the road users, it has to be. So during daytime and nighttime, they serving the purpose, so it is good. Similarly, these attenuators, I have not seen much on Indian roads. This is the basic shortfall I feel. To some extent, this chevron marking help, but these attenuators are more recommended and more required at the point of diversion and all those places. But these I rarely see on Indian road. This is something we need to improve. Then there are solar power struts along with delineator, along with this attenuators, we can have this solar powered struts to make it more visible or more alert. Now there is, I will talk about this delineator. There is one IRC 79/2019. This is the latest code we have for delineators. And now I have seen in many of the Indian roads, we have started using this flexible median marker in a big way, and they are very good, very clearly visible during day and night. So similarly, delineators, we are using more and more of these delineator, median markers, hazard marker. They are also very, very useful. Hazard marker, very, very much clear, yeah, very much visible from a distance. So these are very much required and very much helpful. Similarly, we have these kind of strips of object marker. So they are also, I have seen at the bullnose, they start providing these object marker, and they are very helpful in ensuring the safety of road users. Similarly, roadway indicators, I have mentioned something about their height. They have different height. They are in circular or they are in tubular shape, spacing up to 50 to 70 meters, mild steel or concrete. Here, one thing of important is even retro-reflective sheeting is used here, and it is type 11, the highest category of this sheeting is being used. Warranted on curves and site requirement. So these are very helpful because they are visible from a distance. They are something elevated on the raised median or on any island, wherever some raised this thing is there. So there we can provide, and they are visible from a distance. So this is their applicability. This I have taken from 3M website, I guess. So these are the applicability and roadway indicator, and their particular shape make them more visible to road users. They have black and white strips. White is retroreflective, black is separate. Similarly, I will talk about, because work zone we are seeing, so there is new thing, not new thing, but they are this basic delineator, they don't serve the purpose in work zone. So we have this drum delineator kind of thing, and they serve the purpose beautifully in these kind of temporary work zone, temporary diverse zone, because they are visible from a distance and they are very useful. Similarly, median marker, flexible median marker, have shown to be these are being used and they have a very good visibility during night. So they are being used on median, on crash barrier and all those kind of things. So it is, these are also having a type 11 shooting, so highest grade of shooting they have. Their reflectivity is good, being a type 11 shooting, and they are visible. Similarly, we have hazard marker also on all the these culverts, head walls, and all the bridge head walls. They are generally provided, and they serve the intended purpose provided we have the good maintenance of them. So these are the hazard marker, their utility. Now the object marker. This is one of the photograph from the again from the Gold Coast Road underpass. This is a kind of a tunnel, or you can say underpass around the U-turn kind of facility is there. So there they have used this object marker continuously for this thing, and it served the purpose. It is very bright and very very much visible during night. And so this is a good example of using a safety measure for ensuring safety at U-turn. Similarly, object marker, as I told earlier also, if the hazard is on the road or very near to the road, to be more visible, we have yellow and black kind of option. This is given in the code. And if the hazard is little away from the running carriageway, we can have black and white. So these are the basic guideline or the basic idea. If we have the compulsion, so we can make it more visible with yellow and black. So here I have some photographs showing good and bad practices of road markings, delineators. So here they are roadway indicator installed at the roadside and island indication. So this is like hazard marker is there, plus delineator is there, plus road sign is there, the crossing sign is there. So those kind of measures together, they serve a good purpose. Similarly, there is photograph showing this median marker. They are at 10 meter space or 5 meter space, and they work beautifully during night hours. They will highlight the curb, they will guide the road user what is the running carriageway. So even the median gaps and all those things are also very clear, because whenever some gap is there, so we understand some median gap or something is there, so that can also be highlighted through this. Similarly, object marker and hazard marker here, because of non-maintenance, this someone has pasted some poster on the this hazard marker, so not much is visible, but still they have provided two number of hazard marker and object marker on the bull nose, but still in the absence of maintenance, they may not serve the intended purpose. Hazard marker and object marker, this is the photograph very near to my house. So here I have depicted this hazard marker is provided, but nobody is taking care of this is like I will say it is more unsafe. Why? Because this is a junk piece of metal, and this is just next to the bull nose, and any vehicle ride on that bull nose, so it will have more damage to the vehicle. And because of non-visibility or shitting is not there or non-maintenance, it is not visible, so there is no point in keeping those kind of signs. Instead of keeping this kind of sign, removing it or putting a sheet over there so that they are visible to road users. Now I will show you some work zone safety devices which we are using at we can use at site. Or so here again, this type 4 barricading, they are mainly used in urban section in construction zone. And earlier we were having this good use of these type 4 barricading in metro roads. Now we have more and more use of these type 4 barricading on Indian highways also, road projects also. Then this is New Jersey crash barrier. They are also being used usually continuously on our highway project wherever some deep excavation is there or something there, then this PVC or water filled barricades are there. They are also being used. So I may show you some photograph from my side for where they are being used. Then this is drum damming. These are n number of devices which are available to us, which are being manufactured in India also. So we can make use of these and these options and make the zone, work zone or road side very easily visible to our road users, so that we can minimize the accident, which we can improve the visibility of our road, visibility of our carriageway to road users. These are arrow marking signs, these are flashing devices, rotating beacon, amber light, warning beacons. These are being used at a work zone also we are using. So these are very helpful during night. They just alert the road users that some hazard is there. Example of drawing showing road signs and marking. This is the type of drawings I was telling, because if we don't provide these kind of separate and elaborate drawing showing the markings and road signs, then we may end up maybe at site we place the road sign at the wrong place, because no supervision is there at the time of placing the road sign. So sometimes these drawings can help, or at least even a basic site in charge can, through these drawings, can place the road signs and marking at the right place. This is the basic we can do. This is the first step in providing the road sign and marking and road signs at a right place. These need to be designed. Similarly, there should be a list of inventory wherever road signs are there. Although it is very small, but this is, I have taken from the A3 drawing which we provided for some project. So, similarly, this is another drawing showing wherever some road marking and some features are there, what kind of ghost island and islands are there. So those kind of marking should be clearly depicted to the road user agency, because this is my personal experience. Because the person who is working in the DPR, he is more familiar with this drawings and with these codes, but the person who is working at site, he sometimes is not that familiar with these things, and he generally don't want to put his mind. He just, if you provide him the drawing, a good drawing, elaborative drawing, then he will be able to execute it at site. He is good at it, at executing the work at site, but he is not good going through the code and deciding on its own where he has to place the sign, where he has to place the. So this is the limitation, or this is the basic idea we need to understand, so that we can take a right decision and we can provide the site team with the right kind of information for them to execute in a right way. So that's all from me. Thank you. At the time, now we are open for questions.
Thank you very much. The floor is open for question answers.
I have a question on one of the images which was showing a three lane merging into a freeway. If I could, obviously it's just a very general question. If you could go back to that slide, please. I think that was where we had lost you, and then you came back there.
Is it this Merit Expressway you are talking of?
Yeah, yes, I guess that's okay. The one. Yeah, just
that was almost first slide. Yeah.
Yes. Just a question. This three lane merging onto the freeway, is it uncontrolled, or it's signal controlled?
It is on priority basis they are giving. Give way sign is there, no? You see.
So you just put a yield sign, and you expect three lanes to yield onto a high speed road.
Yeah. That is what, wow. How they have given.
It's very bad, and you have a zebra crossing also.
Yeah.
A recipe for disaster.
This is the problem, na? This is sometimes the problem, because sometimes the person who prepare the DPR, he don't give a detailed drawing for these markings and road sign. He don't decide
sir, it's not only about the road marking. Fundamentally, it is wrong, because you cannot have three lanes merging directly into a freeway. Yeah, because you will have rear end or side swipe collisions. Yes, this has to be either controlled I may not say at a you can have auxiliary lanes, you know, yes. Like kind of acceleration lanes, or you could have some kind of a ramp metering. But there's so much wrong here. It looks very nice when you see so many lanes in each direction. Yeah. It really looks, it's nice on capacity, but it is very poor on safety.
I don't have the detailed drawing of this because we were not part of it. I feel I'm just giving an opinion.
When you have so much experience in road safety, you just look at something like this and you can immediately say.
Definitely. That is very, very much required. Right now, the basic idea is to construct the highway to provide multi-lane highways. Safety is sometimes not that critical. Now, providing mobility
safety
is more important.
Totally, absolutely. It's more of mobility, even if you don't come back home in the evening.
that should not be said, but...
Yeah. No. At times, thing has to be really hard hitting, you know. You can see where the bike is here, you can see the drop on the side, correct?
Yeah, it's actually both sides, it's a design flaw.
So
both sides, you can see there is a design flaw, even the exit also.
Yes.
Exit, they are assuming that a person coming at a speed of 80 is going to take a turn.
And you have a pedestrian who has decided to set off because he feels it is his right of way. You have given him an indication that this is his legal crossing.
Yes.
And that maybe a lane number one will stop, lane number two will stop. The fast lane guy is going to take him over.
It's a big design flaw and will culminate into number of accidents.
I'm not trying to say anything wrong in the design. They did what best they could,
if you are talking about a merging and diverging with a high speed, if you consider the gradient of the speed from the ramp or the side road versus the main through road, there is no place given for acceleration and deacceleration.
Absolutely.
It is direct merging into that track.
Yes. So all of a sudden somebody will come on a main highway.
Yes. Agreed. Fully agreed. Totally agreed, sir.
Yes, sir. Anyway, this is just an observation.
But that's what actually calls for that road safety auditor should be there at the design process.
You cannot expect to fix things when the asphalt is already on the ground when you couldn't do it in the design stage.
Definitely.
Yes.
That is what Rao sir also told. Now NHI is more into safety at the design stage itself. Because once constructed, so it will not be easy for us to make the road safety arrangement on that. So it's better to capture those things at the design stage itself.
Yes. With every stage of audit being neglected, your ability to make changes are drastically diminishing.
Yes.
Proceed
with the project, it's like at the earliest stage, it is far better.
Absolutely, it's just the way the approval process is set. The designers are in a rush to get the approvals because they have to get the drawings ready and the IFC is issued for tendering, and then you have a contractor who is on the ground who has his own targets, and then you have already decided the day the minister is going to come and cut the ribbon. So you know,
this is the basic idea. The road safety auditor has to be a separate entity. It has no way linked to the designer. It has to be a separate entity so that he can have free kind of thing. And it should be a team.
Two auditors
should be there so that they can
Absolutely. By definition, road safety is an independent process of a multidisciplinary and independent team who will review a design or a construction or a pre-opening, but are independent to any of these. So there should be no conflict. In fact, in Abu Dhabi, we have the same situation, but there's a slight conflict that the designer hires the road safety auditor. So the road safety auditor is obliged not to poke holes in the designs, otherwise he doesn't get the next business. Similarly, the auditor is appointed by the contractor at the pre-opening stage, and if he makes it too difficult to open the job by picking up more issues, then the scheme is not going to open and he again loses business. So that independence, it has to be like a financial audit. Somebody from outside comes and he will check everything and pick up all the issues. Now go and fix
yes. In NHI, they have made it this kind of process. But I will quote one example from this supervision thing we are doing in one of the projects. So there, the safety auditor is hired by the contractor, is paid by the contractor. And you can understand that how he will make out the mistakes he the contractor
designed. Straight away conflict of interest situation. The point is that the client is going to onboard this liability. This problem child will be landing on the lap of NHI or MORTA. So they have to make sure that it is as safe as possible before they onboard it.
This process, what you were saying, na, ke, like the any motorist, any accident will happen, he will claim or he will ask the authority to be this design is faulty, or he will prove it in the court and then he will be eligible for good compensation. Those kind of thing, if they start happening in India, so then NHI and all those people, they will start putting more interest or more thought in this process. Otherwise, they are like, yes, everything is acceptable. You have made multiple highway. It is big. It is first time in India. So they are all happy.
Yeah, but Ashish, one thing which I would like to say here is that this safety auditors, actually they should be a totally independent intent entity, even not hired by NHI or by the contractor.
Not hired by the NHI?
Not even hired by NHI or by the contractor. That should be a separate wing to look at it. Then only it works. Otherwise, all those pressures always remains on the auditor. Either side, whatever side you start working, as Shiva said, that if you start putting on many of the hurdles in terms of safety issues, then you are out of the business.
Yes.
Okay, so unless the entity is separate, individuality is being maintained, it is very difficult to ensure each and everything.
I do agree with this thing. You see, it is a open conflict of interest. First of all, the worst kind of conflict of interest, when the safety audit team is hired by the contractor. See, he has to get the COD, and as rightly mentioned, his business gets affected. If he becomes harsh on such issues, he has to close his eyes if he has to continue on the business. So the party should be independent, neither it should be the choice of contractor, and certainly it should not be at all at the choice of contractor. Up to some extent, there should be say of authority, up to say only, they cannot impose it on that one. And right from the design stage and up to the construction stage, that agency should work independently, and preferably what we recommend to NHI and MORTA, the academic institute and research institute should be given the safety audits. At least they will not have that kind of commercial interest. From their business doesn't get affected. So that should be the approach. Generally, we recommend it, but it is not happening yet.
Yeah, what is a person like independent project engineer? So are they enforcing anything in that sense?
Sir, is the question to me?
Maybe anybody, like they used to be in a project of NHI, an independent project engineer.
Yes, there is an independent engineer, but again, on the lighter side, many times it has been mentioned, it is an independent engineer. You see, again, the commercial interest remains there. They are totally depending on the mercy of client, authority, NHI and the contractor. Particularly if you talk about the independent engineer, 50% of the salary borne by the both parties. If it is the authority engineer, 100% borne by the agency, the client. What I mean to say, that party should be independent. You see, it is very much visible on this junction from this one. There is no auxiliary lane, there is no acceleration lane, deceleration lane. How come four lane when two lane have been added here? But this is not visible to the agency when somebody is having a commercial interest with them.
and they will find 100 excuses, the land constraints, some safety barriers, some other issues, and they will make the case through. So that because of these constraints, we can't make it. So every compromise has to be done on the safety aspect. That is happening almost everywhere. It is a land constraint, they don't make it. Leave it. Many times we have taken head on with the authority.
Yes, yes. I think actually Engineer Sikdar in the morning said something very, very beautiful. Money is going to be spent whether you spend it on to make the road safe or you will spend it with crash costs. So yes, you are either going to spend that money to build us. We don't want to build roads. We want to build safe roads, right? It's not just about adding lanes and capacity. We need to make sure that collisions don't happen. And if they happen, they are forgiving. In all of the images that we saw, all the good examples were from foreign countries and all the not so good examples were from our own country. Yeah, and I didn't see one crash cushion in any of the images. All I saw was stickering, you know, so the 3Ms and those companies will have fantastic business in India because they are putting stickers all over the tunnels and everywhere. But then that is too much of information. You just need to give enough information. You know, I saw an image of the tunnel where the whole tunnel strip has got the chevrons. You called it some kind of... It is very good for the business, but it's not required. These are overkill, but because there are so many design flaws and construction flaws, what happens at the end? We are putting tapes and stickers saying, okay, fine, you hit it, it's your problem. Yeah, I'm just giving a perspective from a country where the spending is a little more generous when it comes to this. Yeah, yeah. Thank you so much.
I would like to add something to that. Even if the money is being spent on road safety, I've witnessed many concessionaires and contractors hiring road safety officer for their highway projects, and they are just they are not even civil engineers or people from our field. They are basically people from BCA background or IT background. They do not have the basic knowledge of road safety. What I observed at one place while I was just auditing that place, I just saw a strip in the hazardous section was being put of that set of six strips. Those people were putting the glass beads on the first lay of paint which was supposed to be there. In the 15 mm height of that marking, it is required that the last one, which is 2.5 mm, needs to have the glass bead. And that person was putting the glass bead in the very first of the application of that strip over there. So how are these problems going to be resolved in upcoming time? I don't know. Because lesser amount of knowledge is being sent to these contractors. And if we look into the concessionaire agreement from the section 19 to 27, any and everything about road safety is written. But nobody is... I will tell you one thing.
It finally boils down to the client. Okay, India. If India can arrange the IPL, they can make safer roads also.
See, I tell you, it is basically a paradigm shift. You know, as you know, I repeatedly, you as rightly said that you have to spend even later on. So that is a very common thing. We are not good. You know, we are not habitual in making a preventive maintenance. Maybe it is a road, maybe it is any kind of product. So we only wait that till the accident happens, and then we feel very happy that we have helped the guy to, you know, to be taken to hospital. So obviously, it needs to be a very sincere intention on the part of the client itself. Obviously, the
You're
client
right.
also. So the sincere intent is needed. But unfortunately, these kind of issues, because I also been involved in not many departments, so they get a second when it comes to awarding the project. So only thing what they need to do is that they need to evaluate not only in financial terms, technical terms as well. They should first have an independent body that which will go through that what is there into the contract, what conditions are being met. And also we need to form a rating system, the rating system of the various agency, that if this is a rating system based on their previous works, so within this kind of variation, they may get the preference. That is very much required. The follow-up study is very much required in that system. once we build up this kind of penalties that we have not done it, only then people will realize that they need to take it as a integral component at the very first instance and not as a second instance.
Okay, thank you everyone. It was a wonderful discussion. Good to hear the experiences. So I think we can move forward. If anyone else is having any other questions from the speakers. All right, so in that case, we can conclude the session. So thank you very much, Mr. Ashish Agrawal, and thank you very much, Mr. MS Rawat. It is indeed good to hear the practical field-oriented experiences and the implementations. And naturally, the participants will be able to learn from your experiences you have shared and implement in the field in a right way to make the roads more safer. Okay, so thank you everyone. This is end of the day, and tomorrow again we shall start our first session at 10 o'clock. Have a nice evening.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you all.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you all.